Welcome to Game 7 of Rocket Patriot Football, Joe. Nice to be back home for the last two games.
Yeah.
I'm all fired up today, Joe. You?
Yes, all fired
I'm just making that up. I'm really tired.
Again?
I don't know what it is. Two in the afternoon. I need to take a nap.
It's the Saturday night behavior.
Hey, listen, I want to talk about a couple of guys right down. I don't know if we can see him. Number 41 down here, Sean Beckenhughes. I owe him an apology for last week. He crushed a kid last week. I gave the credit to Stevie Needham.
What's the team, Tim?
You can't blame me, though, right? Because Needham's had an awesome year, too.
He's 44, so.
Yeah, so Sean Beckenhughes, 41, was all over the field last game. He was unbelievable. And another guy, his inverse number 14, Jonathan Grady.
Stepping it up at the right
was
time.
Was awesome last week. Absolutely awesome. I said, that's a guy who deserves to see some more playing time, too. And he may, Joe, here's my nice little segue, he may see some because we are without the talents of Troy Pollack this week. Troy is injured. So he's our top scorer, maybe our most dynamic player, and he is out. So they're going to be asking number 22, Dan Damari, to pick up the reins of quarterback. And for the first time all year, we're going to see number 7, Jaheim Nortellus, join us. He was out on a medical all year. His first game, the poor kid went to all through
all
August. All of August, the worst part of it. Plays his first game in the Game 7. And I'll tell you, he's an athlete. So look for Jaheim, number 7, to get the ball quite a bit. It's hard to say what this Bill Ricketts team really is, Joe. They lost to two excellent teams. They beat three sort of so-so teams, but they always have a good program. They look like they have a ton of kids over there, too. I thought we
numbers.
Had a ton of kids. They may have more than us. And that ends up being a real battle for minimum plays.
Yep.
So minimum plays.
They'll be fresh at the end of the game.
For the first time ever, I think our minimum plays, guys, this might be a team that's actually more guys on than the Rockets. We'll count them up. We'll come back for the kickoff in a second. All right, here's Bill Ricker ready to kick off. Oh, it's a little squib kick. He's going to grab that. That's a first. He grabbed that. I think they get that ball.
There's a flag.
There's a flag. If that went 10 yards, I don't know what the Rockets are doing staring at that ball. That's a live ball, but we got a flag down here. I don't know if they were ready. Offsides. I tell you right now, Coach Pollack should be screaming at these kids up front. If that goes 10 yards, they get a bounce on it. So we might be re-kicking this thing. Go. The Rockets, on the penalty, they get to take the ball without a run back, without a replay, at inside
we'll
Bill Ricketts territory. Hey, we have Fleming and DiCrescenzo, the ground and pounder in there to start the game. It's right to Fleming. He falls DiCrescenzo. Oh, he absolutely mows over number 24, his counterpart. Oh, 23. He was 24 last year. See, this is my steel trap of a mind, Joe. I remember the guy's numbers from previous years. So Lucas is messing me up by changing to 23. But he runs over a guy for for 5 yards. And we got Lucas, 23, and his inverse, 32.
That's Dom DiCrescenzo.
This one goes direct to Dom. They do the exact opposite. Dom's got the first down and more. He's still on his feet. So Dom busts it for a first down, and there's your ground and pound. They go off tackle left with Fleming behind DiCrescenzo. They go off tackle right with DiCrescenzo behind Fleming on the first two plays for first down. Here we are, first and 10 here. DiCrescenzo, Fleming, split right, flash hammer.
Flash hammer.
Pat Dwyer, if he goes in motion, he's going to just be waving his hands to get out of there. He's run so much. This one goes Fleming. He follows, beautifully falls DiCrescenzo. He's still on his feet. Lucas gets about 5+. Nice job. We told you last week, Joe, just grab Dom DiCrescenzo's shirt and fall right behind him.
I would do that.
Lucas is probably one of the few guys who couldn't hide behind Dom because he's a big dude himself. But he's not the biggest dude in the team, is he, Joe?
No,
who
he's
is?
Not. The Diesel.
The Diesel.
The Diesel. Or him carry the ball.
They could Diesel, Lucas, Lorenzo?
Lucas,
you know
Lorenzo.
What? Diesel's a much tougher name than Lukey.
Yeah,
isn't
I
it?
Agree. It's now the Diesel.
Oh, my gosh. Diesel. I like it. We're going to be memorizing 32 nicknames by the end of the season. All right, now we get number 9, Jay Kajander, in there with Dom. This one goes to Dom. He follows Jay. Oh, he's met.
Pushing.
Nice job to hold him up. He's still on his feet. Oh, man, he drags three guys for about 4 yards in the first down. So DiCrescenzo gets his second first down. He was met early and decided he just wanted to carry three or four guys in front of the 5 yards.
Legs moving.
So that's a good start right there. You might see, you know, you see them start the game like this, try to do one or two series early. Why not keep it going, right? Keep it going. If it's working, 5 yards, 5 yards a carry is going to get you in the end zone in about six plays. Now we have our boy Sean Beckenhuisen there.
Not large, but he's a tough one, Tim.
He is tough, man. Was he awesome last week? So Beckenhuisen, Kajander are in there. In motion, there he is, Pat Dwyer. This one goes to Kajander. Oh, he gets met immediately. So nice job by Bill Ricker right there. And that's probably the first time I still get positive yardage, but that was our shortest play from scrimmage here. It's going to be second and call it nine. Second and nine here for the Rockets. We have Fleming back in with Beckenhuisen. Split right, Dwyer. There goes Patrick in motion. Goes direct to Lucas. Oh, he gets outside and oh my gosh! He absolutely crushes number 24. That's the second time that poor kid's got a lick. And you know what? Lucas is just like Kajander and DeCrescenzo. They don't want to go around you. They just as soon go over you.
They do.
Lucas Fleming just crushed this kid, runs another 15 yards, and he gets it down inside the 10. It's going to be first and goal. All right, here we see number 22 and 23. That's Dan Damari in there. He's taking the spot at QB for Pollock this week. It's a direct to Dan. He's going to follow Lucas. David Lynch out there with a nice block, and he gets around him, and there in goes Damari. Easy.
Great start for the Rockets.
Puts it on the gas around the corner. Nice block by number 10, Lynchy. Big body out there, split on the right, and he just follows Fleming. And that's a nice start there for the Rockets.
Very good start. This is a good team, Tim. We should see a very challenging game. It's good to see them come out early like that.
Yeah, for sure. It's you know what? The field position didn't help either, right? It didn't hurt. I thought that was very dangerous play by off that kick because it did go 10 yards, but they said they were actually offsides. And I've never seen it, but I guess they gave the Rockets a choice to take it right where the penalty was, the infraction was. That's perfect. We had to do half the field. Here we go. We're going to try for the extra point here. We're going for the one here now because our kicker, Troy Pollock, is out. This one goes directly to Fleming. He puts his head down, and I don't know if he gets it. Let's see. He does not get it. So Fleming does not get the extra point, and it's going to be with 6:25 here in the first quarter. It's the Rockets 6, Bill Ricka 0. All right, Stevie Needham, number 44, ready to kick here. He boots it. That's a live ball right there. Now it gets picked up immediately. So good play by the guy right in the line and then gets stacked up immediately by Beckenhuisen amongst others. And Bill Rick is going to take over right around midfield. I think Stephen would have liked that to go a little bit farther. But the guy had quick hands. Usually it's not the hands team up front, but he made a nice play. And Bill Rick is going to start off first and 10. All right, here we go. We have our first set here, and that's number 7, Jaheim Nortelis playing back. Free safety, handoff right up the middle, and he gets wrapped up immediately. That looks like big. There he is, the Diesel.
Picks him up
and just gives him an extra little push. Number 24 on number 24. That kid, number 24, got run over twice by our whole Diesel fleet. But Lucas Lorenza comes in and puts a lick on him. He does get about a yard or two, so call it second and 8. Big offensive line there. Fleming, Oki, Diesel, Kajander out left. It's an inside handoff. Oh, nice. He got a little bit of room there. He gets met. It's stacked up after a short gain. So it's going to be third and call it 6 upcoming. All right, third and 6 here for the Rockets. I mean, for the Bill Ricka, that is. It's going to be a pass. He goes back. Throws it underneath. Nice play, and he gets a first down and more. So beautiful play across the middle. Pretty good coverage there, too. I'm trying to see who was on him. I know it was Grady was right in there, 14. He had tight coverage on him, but he threaded the needle, and then Dom DeCrescenzo comes in and puts a lick on him. But it's a first down for Bill Ricka. All right, first and 10 here for Bill Ricka. Nice pass play there. It's a handoff up the middle. Now Oki's right in there, and so is, is that Lucas again? Oki and Lorenza together. Oki slows him down, and in comes Diesel to just run him over. So that's going to be a loss of a yard, and he's hurt too. So going to take a little time out here.
Go.
Hey, Joe, number 20, first-year player, Brendan Foxy Fox. He's a tough guy for one of the smaller guys. Favorite food, pasta, right? Who's his favorite male celebrity? John Cena. You know who that is?
No.
John Cena, World Wrestling Entertainment champion, 15-time champion. He's from West Newbury, Mass.
Cena
is, yeah, yeah. Yeah, because if Foxy was from West Newbury, Mass, he wouldn't be playing for the Rockets,
that's a good
Joe,
point.
Right?
Yeah.
So, hey, how about I guess Cena's a really great guy. He's made the most 400 Make-A-Wish visits, huh? And he was an All-American center for Springfield, Mass College, Division III. He wore number 54. I got to tell Oki that one.
Tell Oki.
So, listen, he said if he we'll get back to the action, come back to Foxy. Second and 10 here. He's going to look to pass here. Right there, that's DeRossi's wide open. He catches it there. Beautiful pass and catch, and he goes in for the touchdown. Grady comes over and hits him. He hits him right in stride. Patrick DeRoss was right with him, and that's the second pass in a row that the Bill Ricker defense, or the Bill Ricker offense, threaded the needle. And they go in for a score, and guess what? That missed extra point could come back to haunt the Rockets right here.
Well, let's stop him here, and it won't.
Wow, two big pass plays turned into huge plays for Bill Ricker here. They tie it up. Also great field position, too. They start at the 50. They're going to go for one here. Throws it underneath, and oh, just throws it a little bit too high. So they miss the conversion, and early on, it's 6-6. We got ourselves a game here, Joe.
We do.
Right? Hey, getting back to Foxy, right? His favorite funniest movie, Paul Blart Mall Cop. Pretty funny, huh?
Shot in the Burlington Mall.
He said if he could be any animal, he'd be a wolf.
Nice.
Wolves are the largest member of the dog family. You know that? And little known fact here, Joe, right? A hungry wolf can eat 20 pounds of meat in a single meal. You know what that is? That's the equivalent of a human eating 100 hamburgers, right? You know where we're going with this, right?
I do.
Which one of the parents could eat 100 hamburgers?
Or
coaches? Well, we know Damari could, because I've seen Damari eat 130 at one sitting. So we have to put him out. But we were talking about this earlier with Steve DiCrescenzo, Domi's father. He'd give 100 a run, easy.
Any time limit, Tim?
You know what? I don't know if there's a time limit. I got
to
find that out. I think Joe Gilligan couldn't eat 100. He can only eat 84, I think, Gilligan. Because he's got to save room for pizza.
That's right.
Right? Here we go. Here's the kickoff here. It's up the middle. They let it go back. It's going to go back to Damari. He's going to get that. It's a live ball. The ball is loose. They got to get on that thing. Wow. Let's see the Rockets. Oh, they don't get it. The ball hits Damari's hands and squirts away from him. And him and Needham can't get on it. So a very tough turnover here for the Rockets. And they're going to have first and 10 from the 20-yard line. So that is a tough one, tough break for the Rockets, and this is exactly what you can't be doing right now against a team like this. Another short field, half the distance of the other one, and with 3 minutes to go, the Rockets are right back on defense. First and 10 here from just outside the 20. Beautiful field position. He's going to go back to pass again. He's got a few of them. Throws up the middle, and Don DiCrescenzo comes up, swats it down, almost pulled it down. Would have been nice to see us come right back with it. Nice play by Dom.
Pick six.
He's playing sort of center field out there for the Rockets. He picked that thing off. Can't get over Dom. So it's going to be second and 10. These guys aren't afraid to throw it. That one was a little bit poorly thrown. His first two were right on the money. So second and 10 here from the 23-yard line. Rocket D is going to have to do something here. They had great pressure on that one, though, Joe. They got right in there. This is a handoff up the middle, and he gets stacked up immediately. Absolutely crunched in there. And there's a whole host of people, including Diesel, Lorenza. They haven't learned. Don't go up the middle. So that one gets pushed back. It's going to be third and 12 upcoming. Here's Bill Ricker swapping out their entire offense. We've seen the Rockets do that, too. They have to, too, with 30-something kids here. This one's always wide open and fortunate for the Rockets. These guys were confusion. It was either Needham or DeRoss. They didn't know who to go with, and we dodged a huge bullet right there, my friends. It's fourth down. You know they're going to go for it here. But but he was wide open and he just overthrew it. So Rockets dodge a bullet there. They like to dodge another one by getting the ball back right here and stopping him on fourth down. Here we are, fourth down and call it 13. It's a big play. You know that they're not afraid to pass. They're going to try it again. The Rockets better get a little bit better on their coverage there. Oh, Kajanda's right there. Right in his face is Jay, and that forces them to throw it early, and they're going to turn the ball over. So
that's a key, Tim. Break up the timing of the play.
Huge play by Kajanda. He's in untouched. He's got his hands on that one. The Rockets avoid a huge turnover, and they're going to take over here first and 10 from their own, let's say, it looks like they're moving the other side here, Joe. So second quarter starting. The Rockets are going to take over from, I think, around their own 30-yard line. All right, here we are. It's Damari and Fleming in the backfield. That's Kenyon in motion there. It's right up the gut to Fleming. Puts his head down. He's still on his feet. And Lucas takes it for a tough three or four right there. I guess it wasn't much of a gain at all. So call it second and 9 here. And it is Needham in the backfield right now. Looks like Damari. And Damari's going to go back to pass. He throws it underneath to Needham. He's got a lot of room ahead of him. Stevie Needham goes up the seam. Oh, vicious face mask right there.
15.
That's going to throw you cheering for him right now. He rips his face down. That's going to add 15 more. They might send that guy out of there. That was brutal. But Stevie Needham underneath pass from Dan Damari. First time Damari throws the ball this year. And it's a big gainer. And there's our boy Needham. So, hey, here's another thing, Joe. This is how tough our fans are here. We have Sean Beckenhuis' mother yelling at him to pull his sock up. He's got one sock down, one sock up.
If you look good, you are good, Tim.
Listen, I think it's a fashion statement by Beckenhuis. And you know, in a 6-6 game, your mom's yelling at you to pull your socks up. It's unbelievable. All right, so here we go. Add 15 onto that. The Rockets immediately go into Bill Ricka territory here. We have Fleming and Damari, 22-23 in the backfield. There's Needham split right, Tice, and there's Kenyon in motion. This one's a keeper to Damari. He's got a lot of room there. Oh, almost set up there. He takes that for close to first down. I saw that one lining up. If Needham got inside of him, Needham would have cleaned out a huge lane for him. And Danny just cuts it up very close to the first down. Call it 1.5 here, second 1.5. We got split left. Looks like Conroy up top. In motion is Kenyon. Direct snap to Damari. It's a handoff to Lucas. He cuts back. Oh, he just gets tripped up. So Lucas tried to spin off of it. And that's going to be probably a loss of a yard there. And call it 3rd and 3 coming up. Call it 3rd and 4 here for the Rockets. Yeah, we were just talking about that, Joe. We'd rather see Lucas just run someone over there trying to get cute.
If it doesn't work, he'll get 2 yards.
Direct snap there. There goes Lucas there, and he goes outside. He's got speed. Wow, he gets out there. He's got the first and more. So Lucas cuts out to the right. Just as we're saying go up the middle, he takes it right. That's why we're up here, right, Joe?
That's right.
How many times can you be wrong in a year, Joe?
Did
you see what I did there, Joe?
I
didn't want us to take the credit for the incorrect stuff.
Tim.
I just say,
no problem.
I'll blame it on you. All right, so first down there for the Rockets, and it's going to be inside the 25-yard line. Okay, here we go. We got Conroy at right, Kenyon left. Double tight end set right here. It's a direct one to Damari, goes off to Lucas. Oh, Lucas is driving and driving and driving. Litchie wants to get in there and pile on number 10, but Lucas takes it for about 6 or 7. Comes in for Fleming. So we have Needham, we have Damari, and we have DeCrescenzo. It's a handoff to Dom right up the middle. Look at the hole that he's got up there. Oh, and he dives for the touchdown. So Dom, he has a hole that you could have driven a diesel truck through.
Offensive line.
And then goes in there. Beautiful play by the line in there. Who's in there in the line? It's
looks like Deemer.
Deemer, Oki's in there. Patrick DeRoss is in there. Lynchy's in there. They opened up a monster hole.
Tim, even you could have scored through that hole.
You know what, Joe? I'm sensing a little bit of sarcasm in your voice there, but I would have scored, but I would have been carted off right now with a hamstring pull.
I would have pulled up at the 5-yard line.
I'm a little dehydrated today, Joe.
Yeah, well.
Yeah, that happens on Sundays. All right, here we go. They're going for 1 here. This is going to be an important point. He goes right to Fleming, and Fleming goes in almost untouched. Almost the same exact play that these guys had. This is Fleming and One Sock. Oh, no, that's Needham there. Needham's got the thing going. I thought it was One Sock Beckenhuis over there. Shawnee One Socks, we call him now. But the Rockets go up. Nice play right there for the Rockets. And a great, listen, they got Helper with the 15-yard penalty. But that first play from Needham to Needham from Damari was a huge one to get us out of the hole. And now with 6 minutes to go in the half, it's the Rockets 13, Bill Ricka 6. All right, we have number 7, Jaheim Nortellis down low. He's taking Troy's spot here. Here's Stevie Needham. Let's see if he can kick this thing away. And he does. Gets picked up around the 40. And he's still on his feet. And Kajanda comes in and cleans him up. So Jay cleans him up for no gain. And Bill Ricka is going to take over first and 10 from the 37. All right, first and 10 here for Bill Ricka. It's like a little wishbone set up there. Handoff right up the middle. He cuts back to get a little room and gets crunched. Lynchy pulls onto him, and in comes 22, Damari and DiCrescenzo. So it's a short gain there. It's going to be 2nd and 9 upcoming. Tell you, this guy, number 9, the quarterback, he's the one who could sling it for these guys earlier. But I tell you, the wind is right in his face right now. It's kicking up. Handoff up the middle, and Oki comes in and wraps him up. Number 54, and he got some other help with him, too. So Oak lands right on him, and let's see who else is there. Lynchy's in there, pulls him up. And number, let's see. I think a 30, I think it was 20. Fleming was in there as well. So that's a pushback right there. Nice job by Oki, Lynchy, and Fleming. And it's going to be 3rd and long. Let's call it 12. This is a throwing downs here. They got 3 split left, 1 split right. Watch Kajander. Gets right in there. They pitch it out. The ball's on the ground. Let's see what happened. Who comes up with it? That's a pushback. They're very fortunate to come up with themselves. They try to pitch play running away from Kajander. They don't have anyone to block for him, you know, against him on those plays. They're spreading guys out wide, and Jay's been in there every play. And now it's 4th and 15 here. You might see them kick it.
They just swapped everybody out. I'm thinking they're going to punt.
This could be a tough one, though, Joe. The wind is whipping out here. We'll see what the net gain is. He does boot it and gets hung up. As we said, look at this. It's coming back. Oh, gosh, a rocket bounce. And it gets picked up. Oh, gosh, look at this. Oh, my gosh, Fleming picks it up, and he goes outside, and he's going to go in. And there's Jaheim's right there. They're going to throw a flag, though. Oh, brutal. I didn't think it was from behind, and they're going to call it on. They're going to call an illegal block on the Rockets and bring it back. So Fleming goes in. I thought he got him right from the side, and they throw a flag down. So they're going to move this one back. Fleming picks up the ball. He just waves his hand down. He's disgusted.
Our coach says, "No, good play."
Picked up the ball. They stopped him on the 4th down. He picks it up. He wants to go in with it. And now I think it's going to be a spot foul back 15 or 10 yards. The Rockets will take over 1st and 10, but unfortunately the touchdown run by Fleming gets called back. All right, we've got a timeout here on the field for the Rockets to take a break. Number 73 is Patrick Duross. We called his name a ton this year.
Great year.
And he's one of the two kids. Him and Einstein Dion are coming back here next year. Two seventh graders. One of the nicknames Oki was telling me is to call him Duhoss. He's a hoss, right? So his favorite food, hamburger. We just talked about hamburgers earlier. It's sort of a recurring theme, hamburgers
100?
And cheeseburgers.
Really?
100? Yeah. Favorite male celebrity, Gronk, right? Funniest movies ever seen, The Benchwarmers. That was a funny movie, wasn't it?
Yeah.
All right, so listen, if he could be any animal, he'd be a moose. And speaking of eating, right, moose can casually devour 73 pounds of food a day. Coach Damari, 74. You knew it. You knew he could beat him.
I was going to say 64.
You knew he could beat him. If you wanted to visit any place, it'd be Alaska, says. We'll come back to Patrick's profile in a sec. We have DiCrescenzo and Damari in the backfield. We look like we're going to throw him down there. There goes Nortellis. He's going to give it to Jaheim. He gets around. Jaheim cuts back. He's still on his feet, so he turns nothing into something. They had some good pressure on him. That's the first time Jaheim's got his hands on the ball. And he's speedy. That one took a little bit longer to develop, though, that play. And we got a 2nd and probably 8 coming up. Getting back to DeRoss, the place he wants to visit, Alaska.
Because he's a moose.
Yeah, little known fact. Alaska was purchased in 1867 by the U.S. from Russia for $7.2 million.
Seward's Folly.
Imagine that. 2 cents an acre. 2 cents an acre. That's how big Alaska is. You know what? I think that's the same amount of what the Pollock's house is worth right now, $7.2 million. So he could either go to Alaska or just go to the Pollock's house. There we go. It's going to be back. He's got Rome here. Oh, he's going to pull it down. Danny. Oh, they run into each other. He cuts back. He turns it for a couple of yards. But Damari was looking to throw there. Had to pull it down. They had good coverage. But he turns it into a gain here. And I think we've got third and about maybe five coming up. Third and five out here for the Rockets. Definite four down territory inside the 20, though, Joe. So we got a couple plays coming up. We have number 7 and 8. That's Nortellis and Conroy. Oh, it's a reverse here. Number 7 is Jaheim coming back. But, they snuff it out again. So give Bill Rickett credit. They're not biting on the reverse. So both of those have moved back. We got probably 4th and 10 upcoming. So credit Bill Rickett's defense on that one. On play here for the Rockets. This is a big one. They'd love to get some more points on the board. It's going to be Damari back to pass. And he's wide open as Dominic. He just throws it over him. Wow. It was a beautiful pass. And Dom DiCrescenzo was out there and floats it up a little bit. And good-looking play right there. And like to see Damari throwing the ball. He's been practicing all week, and he can sling it, Joe.
Got a great arm.
Got a great arm. And you know what? He has a wind right at his back, too. And I think that one just got away from him a little bit. Well, and I think maybe Domi underestimated how far that one was going to go. So they're going to turn the ball over here with 2 minutes to go. The Rockets are only up a touchdown here, Joe. All right, 1st and 10 here for Bill Ricka. 2:30 to go in the half. And you know they can sling it. They got to go some 75 yards here, 80 yards. He's back to throw number 9. He looks over across the middle, and there's Damari spying it. Oh, and Danny comes in. Danny was looking to intercept that ball. Nice coverage by Patrick DeRoss, and playing free safety is Damari, and almost picked that thing off. It's going to be 2nd and 10 upcoming. All right, we have, looks like, split right over here. 3 split left. That's going to be Jaheim, Grady, and Needham over there in coverage. He looks out underneath, and number 24 gets crushed immediately by Jaheim. Nice play right there. That's almost a gain of 1, if that. It's going to be 3rd and call it 9.5 upcoming. All right, 3rd and call it 9.5 here for Bill Ricka. This is tough field position for them. They need to do something on this play. Now it's 3 split right. It's going to be a pitch right. Oh, just gets around Kajander, and it's going to be a good play right here. And he's got the first down and more, and gets cleaned up immediately right there by Damari. But Jay Kajander was in there almost untouched, and he pitched the ball right through his hands. I go, the odds of it going through Jay's hands, and it opened up a huge seam for them. So just when they needed a big play, they got it. And they're close to midfield here with 1:36 left to go. Look for these guys to sling the ball. All right, it's going to be 1st and 10 here from a 44-yard line. 3 guys split again. Look for him to throw it. He goes back. He's looking left. He's got one-on-one coverage with Grady, and Jonathan gets up there. Oh, almost pulls it down. Beautiful coverage with Jonathan Grady back there, and Jonathan almost picked that one off. It floated up there. Jumped a little bit early, but, hey, Jonathan getting the time that he deserves now right on that corner, and he had great coverage right there. Almost came up with a pickoff. Would have loved to have seen that with 1:30 to go, Joe.
That's what we need.
That's where these guys are throwing into the wind going this way, too. And that one hung up a little bit. Grady had a beat on it, knocked it down anyway. It's going to be a keeper. It's a pitch out right. Beautifully set up play. Needham takes an angle on him. Oh, gosh, what a hit over there. Beautiful tackle. But that was a really nicely set up play. They fake it, pitch it out. Gains about 7 or 8. I didn't see who put the big lick on him. Might have been Needham had a beat on him. I think it might have been Damari coming in there and croaked him. So it's a timeout. Bill Ricka on the field with about 1 minute to go. It's 3rd and 4 upcoming. All right, it's going to be 3rd and 4 coming. Clearly 4 down territory with 1 minute to go. And this one's going to be, oh, this play looks like it's broken. Oh, look, it's going to try to be the double pass here. He just flows it up in the air. You got to look up for that one. I think Jaheim, if he put his head up, it would have landed right at him there. They tried a trick play, and it went nowhere. So it's going to be 4th and 4 upcoming. I believe you'll probably see him go for it from midfield, Joe.
I don't know.
A minute to go. It looks like looks like they may have actually called at the half. We're gonna talk to John Demari up here in the booth. He's thinking about
the Patriots.
He's thinking about chicken parm and the Patriots. Yeah. Hey, we're actually happy to see the Patriots this year.
Is there any truth to the rumor that Joe Gilligan called Roger Goodell and said,
I think he said you need to move it. Joe Gilligan, as you know, is obsessive about the Patriots, and he tells everybody, do not dare give me an update.
The stress is getting him, so I think he made a phone call.
Yeah, I think, well, you know what, if anybody has the cachet and the power to push Roger Goodell around, I think it's Joe Gilligan. So, hey, at the half, and the Rockets, I think they're going to be kicking the ball off in the second half. The half, it's Reading 13, Billerica 6.
My name's Alyssa Luis, and my favorite celebrity is Tom Brady.
You go to a point.
I'm Caroline Broussard.
I'm Kate Philcon.
Hi, I'm Jessica Newton.
My name's Samantha James.
Hi, I'm Sophia Bonfilio.
I'm Sophie Lightbody.
Hi, I'm Olivia Fido.
Hi, I'm Ashley Capey.
Hey, while we're here at halftime, player profile number 54, Dan O'Connor. I used to be able to call him Danny when you're younger.
I just call him Okie.
Just call him Okie. That's what his favorite food, Cajun chicken pasta from Chili's.
From Chili's.
Right? Turned on. That was Trev Conroy who turned the whole family onto it. Favorite male celebrity, David Ortiz. Funniest movie Okie's seen, Anchorman. That movie is funny, is it? Remember Ron Burgundy?
Burgundy.
The description of Ron Burgundy. He had the voice that could make a Wolverine purr. And suits so fine they made Sinatra look like a hobo. Remember that line? That was the best. All right, listen, if he could be any animal, he'd be a bear. I think I remember this from a few years ago. And I thought it was like because he could be ferocious. And at that time, a few years ago, he said, no, because they sleep like 6 months out of the year.
Oh.
But bear, hey, get a load of this. Bears can run 40 miles an hour. Fastest human, Usain Bolt, runs how much? How fast?
26.
Joe, 27. How about you, huh? We're wrong again, Joe.
Wrong again. That's close, Tim.
You're right in there. If he could visit any place in the world, go to Hawaii. I'm not taking him there. You know how expensive Hawaii is?
That's
crazy.
It's a long time to get there.
I hope he might go to college in Hawaii. That's the only way he's going to get there. But anyway, number four is Okie. He had a birthday last week.
That's right.
14 years old. How about that, huh? Yeah, he's growing like about 2 inches every 3 months, Joe. So he's a big dude. He's got to throw a little beef on him, though. So number 54, close to my heart, Okie. We're going to come up for the second half. Hey, it was great to have the girls, the cheerleading squad here,
huh? Yeah, that was fun.
A little nervous up here, the girls.
They're getting on camera.
Yeah, they were okay, but it was good to get the girls up here. We got a little bit of extra time here at halftime, and we'll be back shortly. All right, Stevie Needham set to kick off here in the second half. See if we can boot this one away. He does give it a nice kick there. Wow, ball bounces up. Good. Oh, God, it looks like a hit from behind over there. He's still on his feet, this guy. He gets wrapped up. I thought Jaheim got crunched from behind. The guy's right in front of him and doesn't throw a flag. So a nice little run back here close to midfield, and Bill Rick is going to take over first and 10. First and 10 here from midfield. The wind in their favor this way. This is where they made some nice connections. It's the keeper. He's got room up the middle. Wow, cutback. He's still on his feet. So Patrick DeRoss makes a shoestring tackle at the end. But I tell you, it was a long run. He only got 10 yards out of it. I think he ran 20 yards. But it's going to be very close to the first down. They give it to him. So first down from the 40. All right, first and 10 here after the 10-yard gain. Two split right, two left. This one's going to be a keeper, and he gets met, wrapped up by a bunch of different guys in there. Gang tackle by the Rockets. That's one of the things that they do very, very well. Number 52, Einstein in there. He gets a nice hit in there, and then probably about four other guys. So call it second and 9 upcoming. All right, second and actually 10. No gain right there on the nice tackle by the Rockets. That's something they've done well all year long. This one's going to be an inside handoff. And he gets met immediately, runs right into Okie, stops him. And once again, in comes number 65 is Wasabi Masucci. Number 10 is Lynchy. So Okie up the middle, and then number 10 and 65 crunch on either side. And that's a nice job. So third and long upcoming.
He comes at.
They switch out the entire
right the
team. That's what the Rockets have to do, too. They clearly, Bill Rick is going to do the same thing with a huge roster over there, 30 guys. Look for a pass here. He's going to be looking over to the right, and he does. He's looking for number 36. It's across the middle, and he's on. Oh, what a pass and catch. Patrick DeRoss had perfect, perfect coverage on him, and he threads the needle. So that's going to be another first down here. And looks like Kajander is a little bit shaken up behind the play, but he looks like he's running right in there. So big first down right there. 7 minutes to go in the third. And Bill Ricker moving the ball. All right, first and 10 here from the 26-yard line. Beautiful pass and catch. This kid's been threading the needle this way.
Nice quarterback.
Ooh, this was keeper up the middle and absolutely gets tattooed. Is that our boy Oki? Danny O'Connor comes in and crushes this kid in the backfield, pushes him back 6 or 7 yards. Jumps up like he's got hot sauce in his pants, right? See, he's very happy with himself, Oki.
I would be too. That's a great play.
I'm jumping up and down like that too, Joe. You know how we like to live vicariously.
Absolutely.
Great play by Oki.
Since we can't play it, we might as well.
He gets in and crushes, pushes him back 7 yards. It's a low pass. They're going to try to swing it out. Oh, boy, look at this. Pumped in the air. And they almost come down with it. That one was spied out very easily by Nortelis and Damari. And Lynchy's out there, too. Oh, my gosh. If that came down in the Rockets' hands, it was nothing but green in front of them. So it's going to be third and long upcoming. Then Bill Rick is fortunate not to turn the ball over in that play. All right, third and call it 15 here. Not afraid to throw it. And like I said, wind at their back. Watch DeRoss down low. Tight coverage. He's going to air it out. He airs it out right down the middle and throws a little bit too far. So Stevie Needham had good coverage, but the guy did have a step on him. And this is what we said last time. This is what happened to Damari. The wind with him actually let it sail a little bit. So now it's fourth down here. And this is a huge play. The Rockets would love to get this one back.
I agree. The wind will be in Bill Ricker's face in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, the Rockets would love to get it back here, up 7. But they've had some big quick strike. We've seen what they can do, so you're going to definitely be looking for a pass here. Let's see if we can get that big offensive line. Lynchy, Kajander, Diesel, Oki, and Fleming. Let's see if we can get a pushback from those guys and disrupt the play. Three guys left, one right. He's been trying to go with the isolation on the guy on right. Oh, they jumped off sides. That has to move Bill Ricker back another 5. So I'm sure it's not even going to change the play. It's just going to make it 4th and 20 instead of 4th and 15. But they should walk off 5 here. All right, here we are, 4th and more than 20 here. They're definitely going to air this thing out. Oh, no, he's going to kick it. Wow, so they kicked the ball. Oh, nice, fortunate bounce for the Rockets. It ends up being really a net gain of maybe 15 yards there, but the Rockets are going to take over here. First and 10 from the 20, so they kicked the ball. That's a big, big stop for the Rocket D there. They had some very positive play. They started at the 50, a couple of big plays to get down the 20, and it stalled. The Rocket D stepped up, and they're going to get the ball back here, Joe, with 6 minutes and 40 seconds to go in the third. Going, right? All right, here we go. It's going to be Damari in the backfield with Fleming. Split left is Tice, Nortelis, and DeRoss. And Danny's going to look to – he pitches it out to Fleming. He's got a great play there, a nice pushback. It's a good job. He stays his feet, reverses direction.
Still going.
He's still going. This, we talked about the other guy running 20 yards for 10. He just ran about 30 for 7. So it's a good-looking play right there, and it's going to be 2nd and 2 upcoming. All right, it's going to be 2nd and 2 here. We have Nortelis in the backfield with Damari. Behind them is Fleming. Oh, boy. Oh, the ball's on the ground. Wow, I think the Rockets got it. We hope they got it. But there was a missed exchange up there. It was a little bit of a high snap that Danny had to pull down, Damari. And in the exchange, he ran into, I think it was Fleming coming up there. So They lose the down. They go back a yard. It's going to be third and three coming up here. You know, number 22 is Dan Damari. He's our quarterback today. His nickname, the Little Sausage.
The Little Sausage.
You know why they call him the Little Sausage, right?
Because he's got two bigger brothers.
Well, his dad is the Big Sausage.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So get a load of this. I'm not kidding you. This week, Coach Dan Damari is texting me pictures of chicken cutlets.
How was that like? Did you go last week?
I did not go last week, but I'll tell you, he's literally – I mean, there was a pile of chicken cutlets that could have fed a wolf. So here's a handoff up the middle. Oh, big hole right there. Oh, and Lucas takes it for a first down and more. He drags three guys with him. So Fleming, tough run right there.
Fleming had a white jersey on there, Tim.
He had three white jerseys on. It looks like he had six legs, too. So Damari is sending me pictures of chicken cutlets. And here I am last week. I'm giving all this credit to Jill Damari. And little Dan tells me during the week, he goes, my father's the cook.
Oh.
How about that, huh?
Well, let's have him over, Tim.
Hey, Danny's favorite male celebrity, Tom Brady. Awesome. Favorite female celebrity, Selena Gomez. All right, first and 10 here. Damari's going to get the snap, right? Fleming is next to him. That's Tyson motion. It's a handoff to Lucas. He goes off tackle. Oh, he's, you know what? He is deceivingly quick on the outside. He bounced it outside and takes it for about 15. So Lucas is, you know, he's a guy that I said he could easily cut it up. Right? He bounces it outside, takes it, and he's got his speed on the outside is deceiving because he's such a big guy. He's huge, so he takes that into Bill Ricka territory here. We get some breathing room going on here. If Danny could be an animal, Danny Damari, lion.
Lions, bears. Yeah.
Get a load of this one. We asked who they wanted to nominate for president. He wanted to nominate Diesel Lorenzo.
Diesel.
Lucas Lorenzo, president. All right, here we are, first and 10 from midfield here. That's Tyson motion. It's going to be a keeper for Danny. Oh, he makes an athletic play. They have a good play, number 65. He's a big dude. He had some good pursuit on him there. So that's going to be a loss of a yard there. That one's worked very, very well. You've seen Troy do that too, where they basically let everyone on the right side leave them unblocked, see if they're aggressive and bite on it. But that one goes nowhere, so – credit Bill Ricka's defense on there, in particular, big number 65. Okay, it's going to be second and call at 12 now after the pushback. That's Conroy down low with Nortelis. Up right is Tice and Duras. There's Jaheim. The ball is fumbled, and it's going to be picked up by Bill Ricka. Wow, big number 65. They missed the handoff. And Danny Damari has a touchdown-saving tackle. So a couple of turnovers here by the Rockets are really hurting them in this game. And they're probably keeping this game a lot closer than it should be. With 3 minutes to go, they're only up a touchdown. And now Bill Rick is going to take over with unbelievable field position right here. So they missed the exchange. It was going to be a sweep to Nortelis. The ball goes on the ground. And big number 65 picks up. He looked like Vince Wilfork there picking up, trying to run it down. And they're going to take over first and 10. He's back to pass. He's going to throw it underneath. Oh, wow, beautiful throw. He just drops it. Stevie Needham was on it, but he put it right in the guy's hands, 81, and fortunate for the Rockets, he didn't pull it down. All right, it's going to be second and 10 here. Three split left, one right. Oh, it's going to be a pitch out here, and he's got a lot of room there. He cuts back. There's going to be there's a flag. I think we might have a hold on Bill Ricka. Let's see. And it is. And they were holding Patrick DeRoss by the shirt, and I think they're going to move him back 10.
DeRoss.
Let's hope that they're holding DeRoss. DeRoss had one guy on him, and I think that let's move this one back. We'll see. Rockets are clapping, so they're going to push this one back and make it third and 10. It's going to be second and 15 here after the hold. That was a very nicely set up play, that pitch. That's worked well for them. But the hold's going to bring it back. He's going to go back to pass, and he throws it up underneath. It just goes through his hands. So once again, Bill Ricka snake bit right there. I'll tell you, for the Rockets, you could tell that there's a little bit of timing miscommunication, and maybe those are the games that Jaheim has missed, right? The timing's a little bit off, but it's also being thrown off, getting a couple of high snaps too. And one of our regular, that's another thing too, we have one of our regular centers is Sean Cronin, number 64. He has been
out
the last two games. So when you see a little bit of those high snaps, it can sort of, pull the timing off just by a second here. And it's going to be third and long upcoming here. Look for him to throw the ball. Goes underneath. He throws it right across the middle. Oh, wow. Hits his hands. Duros is there, and what a hit by Damari. We just had a big lick by Danny Damari to come in and meet him at the same time. And he's down. He's catching. I think he might have knocked the wind out of him there. But huge play. Could be a kick here with fourth down. I tell you, they've been slinging the ball. They put it right in the three guys' hands, and they dropped it. It's going to be a kick. He kicks it. We got Damari back deep. Danny better either let that stay away from that thing. Just stay away from it, Dan. Right there. Perfect. And now the Rockets, they're going to have great field position. That's exactly what Bill Ricker wanted to do. But credit Damari to get away from that one. The last one hit off his foot, and Bill Ricker pounced on it. So it's going to be 95 yards to go, but the Rockets are going to take over here. 2 minutes to go in the third. Looks like we got Kajander in the backfield with Fleming. Back to the ground and pound here. Maybe give him a little bit of breathing room here, the Rockets. That one goes to Fleming. He follows Jay. He bounces outside, cuts back up, still on his feet here. And Lucas takes it for about 6 yards, a little bit of breathing room over the 10. So nice 6 yard gain. You get 6 yards a gain, Joe.
That's first down.
Keep going. So the Rockets have a ton of offensive weapons, though, when you think about it. What they've used this year, maybe their biggest one is on the sidelines right now, number 11, Troy Pollock. But they'll use Kajander. They'll use DeCrescenzo. They'll use Fleming. They'll use Damari. Now we have Nortelis in the mix. They'll use Beckenhuis back there. All sorts of weapons. This one goes direct to Kajander. He takes it. What a hole up the middle. And Jay, once again, we know Jay, right? Don't cut left into the big hole. Cut right so you can run someone over. And that is something, man.
That offensive line's doing a great job in the middle, Tim.
Yeah, who's in there? That's this big Wasabi Masucci. Giancarlo Musto's in there. Foxy's in there. Pat Dwyer's in there. Nice job. Dave Swanson in there, too. Open up a big, huge hole, and that's a first down. There we go. Fourth quarter, it looks like. So we're going to change sides here, going to the fourth quarter. The Rockets up just a touchdown. They'd love to add a little insurance on this drive. All right, call it first and 10 here for the Rockets. It's a direct snap to Fleming. He's still going. Gets outside, lowers his shoulder, and takes it for a 6 or 7. So Lucas gets out close to the 30-yard line. It's going to be 2nd and 2 upcoming. All right, let's call it 2nd and 2 here after the gain by Fleming. We have Kajander and Fleming in the backfield. Lynchy split right. That's Pat Dwyer close to us. It's going to be a keeper with Kajander. What a hole he has there. And there goes Jay. Oh, he might just get pulled down at the end. Very fortunate play, number 36. Jay gets dragged in the end. Hopefully he's going to be all right here. But Jay rips one off for about 35 yards into their territory. But he got pulled down from behind it. It was awkward the way he went down on the back. But I think, let's hope Jay gets up here soon and we'll come back shortly. All right, we have Sean Beckenhuis go in there, take over for Jay while he's out. Jay did get up and he walked out under his own power, so hopefully he's fine. The direct snap right there goes to Lucas. He follows a nice block. And Lucas takes this for very close to the first down. He might be a foot short, but nicely set at play. He falls Beckenhuis. I must have called Beckenhuis' name 19 times last week. Between him and Jonathan Grady last week, I called their names more than I call my own kids. So here we are. Yeah, 14-41. We got 2nd and 1 upcoming here. This is a nice drive here for the Rockets. They want to keep this one going,
just
though.
Just churn out the clock. If they can score here, Tim, it's looking very good.
Well, I tell you, it looks like a game that the Rockets maybe not playing their best game. They're not executing and turn the ball over a couple of times, right? And listen, get that out of your system now, because if you do it to one of the brass, and we're going to be seeing some of the brass next week is Woburn, and those guys will make you pay. Here's a keeper for Beckenhuis. Oh, big hit, but he gets the first down and more inside the 30-yard line.
Tim, we're seeing some big holes. That offensive line is just dominating at this point.
Yeah, I tell you. The big line is Masucci, and we got the Greek Freak is back out there. Pete Mirogiannis?
Mirogiannis.
So Pete's a big boy. He's making a lot of room there. And so's Lynchy as well. Yeah, that big line is opening up some holes, man. Big ones.
Yeah, a little Foxy in the middle there, too.
We got Ramos and Musto on the left-hand side, too. Direct snap to Lucas. He follows Sean, puts his head down, dives it close to the 20-yard line, so it's going to be, call it, very close to another first down there. It's going to be, this is what hurts here. This is what hurts for these guys, because you can't be ripping off 8 or 9 in your first down and expecting these guys to stop it in what's clear four-down territory. So the Rockets looking to hold on to the ball. What they don't want to have here is a miscue.
No.
They've had a couple of them, and fortunately they haven't paid for them. But like we said, next week upcoming is Woburn, and that's a very, very tough team. And after that, it's playoff time, Joe.
Yes.
Right now the Rockets are still undefeated, only up 7 here, though. Oh, boy, low snap. That's smart for Jay just to get that one. So we said we're trying out from some new snappers there. And that one, smart play by Jay there.
I agree.
Moves him back a couple. But guess what? It's third down
third
here.
Down, we're
definitely, like
four
we said,
down territory.
Good play for Jay. You know what? Once the knee's down anyway, they're going to blow it down. But nonetheless, it's going to be 3rd and 5 upcoming. And going to that big right side of the line is Lynch, Mirjanis, and Masucci. Looks for him to go that way. And it does go that way. He follows Jay. He bounces outside, and he's got some room. He's around the end. Gets pushed out, but another first down by Lucas. He's looking to follow Jay. He bounces it out. I'll tell you, we talked about before, deceptive speed by Fleming because he's such a big guy. These guys are taking brutal angles on him because he's already passed them. They're trying to close on the big guy, and he's turning these outside plays that he's bouncing out into big plays. I personally like to see Lucas throw his head down and go right at the middle again, too. He's a big enough guy to steamroll some people. So 1st and 10 here from the 14-yard line. Rocket drive looking very good. Ground and pound is back in there, right? Split right, Pat Dwyer. It's Kajander and Fleming. This time they go the opposite way. What a hole right there. And Lucas is still on his feet. Wow, is he hard to bring down. He's still in. He's got to go in. I think he's in. He is. Lucas Fleming refused to be brought down. That was sort of a counter play, and they went right over the left side there. I think that left side of the line was Foxy over there and Max Ramos.
Max Ramos, I think I saw Dylan Lee as well.
Dylan Lee, 12 in there too, right? So Dylan Lee, Max Ramos, the Worm, Giancarlo Musto over there, and Foxy, and they open up a huge hole, and Fleming runs through it, and that's a much-needed breathing room for the Rockets right here. It's 19-6 with 7 minutes to go, and we're going to see the conversion upcoming. Controlling the line now, aren't they? Yep.
They are, Tim.
The Rocket line, offensively and defensively, just controlling them. This is going to be Damari, and Damari's going to roll out to pass. He's got Pat Duras wide open, no one covering him. And he floats it up there, and Duras pulls it down easy. Duras looks like he was going to set up a tee over there.
He had a chair.
He's going to get in a chair at coffee and waiting for the ball to land in his lap, and it does. So nice pass from Damari to Duras. Duhas, right, Patrick? And great job right there. And the Rockets get some, like we said, much-needed breathing room. Right now it's 20-6 with 7 minutes to go in the fourth. Stevie Needham set to kick off here after the Fleming touchdown. It's a nice boot right there. Oh, it's over his head. I wonder if he touched it. Did he touch that? I think he's going to throw a flag. If it goes out of bounds, there's normally a flag, but I think he touched it. So they're going to actually land right where the 31-yard line is there, and they're going to take over. It was a nice kick by Needham. And Bill Rick is going to take over here. Listen, I don't know if this clock is right up here, Joe. We have the whole entire Damari family here. Johnny Damari's running the clock. And I swear to God, he's just looking right at his fantasy football on his phone right now.
I thought he was sleeping in there.
He's dreaming of chicken cutlets.
Chicken cutlets.
So
I don't blame him.
Johnny's over. He's like, when can I go home and let me check my fantasy football score? Oh, by the way, there's a game going on. So the whole Damari family represented here. Up in the booth, two guys on the sidelines. Jill Damari, obviously, somewhere down there in the stands.
Mr. Pollock's not happy about something here.
Well, they look like they're moving it. They're moving the ball. Oh, I think they might have blown the flag on that. They say if he didn't touch it, the ball goes out of bounds. Then you would say that it is a penalty, and they'd move it to I think the 45-yard line, which is exactly where they looks like they're moving it. I think Coach Park is saying that kid touched it, and that's it. He touched it, so it's technically a fumble out of bounds. So it looks like Bill Rick is going to get excellent field position here, and Coach Pogg's not happy about it. After all said and done, Pollock gets his way, and they move the ball back, which they should have. He touched it. There was no flag thrown. Inside handoff here. Number 34's got some room. Still on his feet. Wow, gets picked up at the very end. I think Damari is in there. Let's see who else. Damari and Needham in there, but that was a pretty nifty play there. No one really picked him up. He rips it off for about 7, so call it maybe 2nd and 4 upcoming.
Lynchy's coming in.
In comes big Lynchy. Out goes Diesel. He's spelling the Diesel. He said the Diesel was sick this week, Joe, yeah?
He was sick a few days.
Wasn't feeling that good. Well, I tell you, the way he played early on, he didn't look sick. Look for them to try to throw the ball here. It's right up the middle. Up, still on his feet, and in goes Needham. Gets pulled down from behind, too, as Oki was in there. And let's see who else. Lynchy. Oki and Lynchy grab him from behind, and Needham comes in and cracks him. But they're very close to the first down here, right about the 40-yard line. So, odd that they're going to run the ball like this with that much time.
Too. They need 2 touchdowns.
They need to throw. Listen, they've shown they can throw it.
Absolutely.
They've hit it. I know the wind's not in their favor in the fourth quarter here, but they're running this clock down. They need 2 scores.
And they haven't had any success running up the middle. I don't want to jinx the Rockets, but they've been good out in the wing and throwing the ball.
Inside handoff here. Big hole right there. So you get the first down and more. Literally gets picked up and lifted by Jaheim.
We have a timeout.
So nice tackle by Jaheim here, but it's going to be first down, and it looks like they did call timeout to stop the clock here. Or maybe just to move
the
chains.
Just move the chains, okay.
So they move the chains. It's going to be 1st and 10 from the 45 upcoming, and Bill Rick has got to do something here. I don't know why you don't want to be throwing the ball here.
I agree.
At least stop the clock, but we know they can do it. And right now they have a formation that looks like they're going to. It's the pitch out here. Oh, Duros closes quickly and crunches. So Patrick Duros did a very nice job there because they get the one-on-one. They try to block him down. Once he saw that pitch go out, he took off. That's a play that if they do the pitch and they run it out, you could potentially double pass that thing if Duros bites on it. But he bit on it there, and he crunches him for a loss. All right, it's going to be 2nd and 10 here. He's going to put the ball in the air now. He throws it out here. Oh, there, what a play right there. Jaheim Nortellis comes in, and that's the athletic play we've been looking for here out of him. Gets his timing down in this play, Joe. Good time for the Rockets.
It would have been nice to see him catch that and fly to the end zone.
Oh, listen, if he caught that, he could have crawled to the end zone. But what a nice play by Jaheim. Really telegraphed that pass, too. But you know what? The bottom line is the clock stops for him, and it's a third down play upcoming, 3rd and 10. All right, it's going to be 3rd and 10 here for the Rockets. I mean, for Bill Ricca, that is. Looks like a passing down here, and it is. He drops back. He slings it across the middle. Oh, Sean Beckenhuis, number 41, and there's his buddy, Jonathan Grady, 14. Beckenhuis almost pulls that down over the middle, and that would have put a stamp on it right here for the Rockets if he did. But guess what? This play may put a stamp on it anyway. It's 4th down. They need 10 right here, or the Rockets are going to take over with under 5 minutes to go in the game, and that will be all she wrote, I think. So this is the game for Bill Ricca right here. Let's see if that Reading defensive line can do something here. We got Kajander in there. We have Dion. We have Oki. In the middle is Needham. Needham and DeRoss out on the wings. Nortellis and Grady over here. Here's the throw. It's a long throw across the middle. Oh, boy, beautiful pitch and catch. And Danny Damari comes in. I think Damari actually landed on the shoulder, so he gave himself a stinger. But how about that? They needed 10, throws it right down the middle into the wind, and the kid pulls it down for 15. So Danny's shaking up on the play. We'll come back in a second. And 10 here for Bill Rick after the beautiful pass and catch right there. These things have actually been defended pretty well, Joe, and these guys are pulling them down.
Give Bill Rick a credit. A nice.
Oh, right there. Right, Kajanda's on him. Oh, nice. Kajanda trips him up. Beautiful play by Jay to stick with him, drives him, and brings him down.
Clock's still moving.
Good thing he did, because I saw Lucas Fleming coming in. He was about to tattoo that kid, but the clock is running, Joe. As you said, they finally listened to us and started passing, but now this thing gets pushed back 10 yards after the pursuit by Kajander. Okay, it looks like we might be down to the two-minute warning here. Bill Rick, a definite pass. Oh, the ball's on the ground, and he gets mauled by Oki. Is in there, and Fleming. The ball drops. Oak gets right in there and crushes him. Don't give him an extra second. So that's another great play by Oki up the middle. He had another one earlier.
The defensive line's doing just as well as the offensive line, Tim, and that's been the difference in this game.
Yeah, great play right there. Didn't even get a chance to move it. Now it's 3rd and 17. Bill Rick going backwards the last two plays, Joe. Three split right. You're going to look for a pass here. Is Grady on a one-on-one down here below? He's going to look that way, too. He throws it underneath. Oh, absolutely tattooed. Give him credit. Pulling it down. But Sean Beckenhues puts a lick on him. They gain about 2 yards, if that. And this is 4th down right here. And that's 4th and a long way. They got to get inside the 30-yard line to about the 28 here. So look for another long pass upcoming. And the wind's not in Bill Ricker's favor right here. It's whipping. So that ball can get hung up there. Look for the Rockets. This might be the chance you see the Rockets pull one down and go the other way. I'd like to see it. How
just
about a prediction,
knock
Joe?
Knock it down.
You know what?
Too.
On 4th down, you're right.
Knock it
the
down.
Kid, you just knock it down. You get the ball back, right?
You got Damari deep in safety.
Way back is Damari. Oh, look at the pursuit. Oki right in his face. Oh, boy, he gets around him. So nice play. It turns into something here. Oh, he spins on him. Oh, gets pulled down. So, wow, they may not get it. Wow, he got it by a yard too, Joe. He just got in there. Very close. He needed to get to the 28. It looks like he's on the 28. Oh, sorry, the 25. So that play, nice spin move at the very end, and they turn into a 1st down. But we're getting way late in the game here. I don't know how much time is left.
It says 23 seconds.
And Bill Rick has called timeout. It looks like they're going to call a couple of plays here. But guess what?
You're down
14, but you want to try a quick strike and then an onside kick, and that's really their only chance here. But huge pursuit again by the Rocket defensive line on that one. They turned that play into a big one. Here we are, 1st and 10 here after the nice play by Bill Ricka, throwing it underneath. It's going to be a long throw here, one-on-one, and it's intercepted by Grady.
Is that
Grady? It is Grady. Oh, no, it might be Stevie Needham. No, it's Grady. 44. I can't see that far, Joe. My head's getting in the way of the camera. Who just made a prediction, Joe?
I think it was Tim O'Connor.
I think it was, but of course that was just a play too late on the 4th down, right?
As long as it was an interception.
You know what? Jonathan Grady has been playing a ton the last two games, deservedly so, and he came up big right there. He almost had one earlier in the game too. So the Rockets turn the ball over here, and I think you're just going to see them kneel on it here.
Yeah.
You know, this wasn't it's a little bit of a sloppy game for the Rockets here. You know, back on the home field, wasn't their best. But you know what's nice? You get to see a team that throws the ball a lot, and they had to defend it. And you're going to see guys in the playoffs who can do just the same thing. So the Rockets are going to kneel down here, and that's going to do it for us there, Joe. As the clock runs out, they're going to go to 7-0 right now with 1 game left in the regular season. We're going to see Woburn right here next week. Woburn is also undefeated. I don't know who Woburn has. Woburn's playing Drake it today.
That's a good game.
So that could be a good game. So we could have a battle of unbeatens here next week once we find out that Woburn score as the boys line up to shake hands. So the Rockets probably the better team here.
Yeah, especially on the line. They dominated on the line.
They dominated both sides on the line, and even with some sloppy play, they took care of Bill Ricka. But you know what? That's the type of sloppy play they cannot have next week against a tough Woburn team. And you certainly can't have it in one-and-done playoffs after this. So this is really tight. There's 3 undefeated teams out of this division, Joe. Acton, Boxborough, Woburn, and the Rockets. That Malden team's 5-1. Everett's in there, so there's some really tough teams in the playoffs. Rocket's obviously going to the playoffs, but they have one more game left in the regular season. And we'll see you next week at Woburn, right, buddy?
We'll be there. We'll be here, Tim.
I love it. I love being back at home.
I do too.
All right.
Closer to the chicken cutlets at the
moment. Hey, off to the Patriots.
Off to the Patriots. Gilligan's gone.
Gilligan is running right now to go see the Patriots for the first time live all year. All right, see you guys.